afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the Big 50 reception presented by Gaston County Schools. I am Todd Hagans, Chief Communications Officer for Gaston County Schools, and we are delighted to have you with us here at the Gastonia Conference Center for today's program. This is what we like to call a three-in-one event, because we have three reasons for being here, and the purpose is to celebrate each one. Today, we are celebrating our school mentors. We also are celebrating our business and community partners, and we are celebrating the culmination of the Big 50 anniversary for Gaston County Schools. We are going to hear more about our 50th anniversary later in the program, but it crossed my mind earlier today that we are in the perfect place to bring our anniversary celebration to a close. It began right here in downtown Gastonia last September, just a block away on Main Avenue, I think that way. Is that right, Mayor? That way. With our Big 50 parade in September, and today we are coming full circle with a celebration by being back in downtown Gastonia here at the beautiful Gastonia Conference Center for our final Big 50 program. At this time, to bring greetings on behalf of the Gaston County Board of Education, please welcome our chairman, Mr. Brent Moore.
Good afternoon and welcome. It's a pleasure to have you with us for the Big 50 reception. Before I begin, I'd like to recognize the members of the Board of Education who are with us today. Please stand when I call your name. Kevin Collier, he's our Vice Chairman. Ms. Dot Cherry, Mr. Justin Davis, Mr. Lee Deadman, Mrs. Dot Guthrie, Mr. Steve Hall, Mr. Jeff Ramsey, and Mr. Terry Ushery. It is wonderful to be here at Gastonia Conference Center for what really is an extra special event for Gaston County Schools. Not only are we celebrating our 50th year anniversary, but today we are recognizing important groups of people who are key to our overall success. Honestly, I can't imagine what it would be like without school mentors and our businesses and community partners. You are so important to what we do every day. For me, saying thank you just doesn't seem like enough. Your contributions are many. The hours you give to supporting our schools are countless, and the influence you have on our children and our community is priceless. We are so fortunate to have more than 400 business and community partners supporting Gaston County Schools. Many of you are represented here today. The list includes businesses, organizations, churches, civic clubs, and individuals who have extended a generous helping hand to our schools and invest a great amount of time, money, manpower, and resources to support our students and teachers. I'm so glad to know when we need help, help is just a phone call away. Equally important to our school mentors are more than 200 caring adults who give at least 1 hour a week to be a positive influence on the life of a child. Your work does not go unnoticed, and the time that you spend with our children is the most significant contribution anyone can give. On behalf of the Board of Education and everyone associated with Gaston County Schools, we want to say thank you for supporting us and being there for us. We appreciate you and are so fortunate for you to be a part of Gaston County Schools family. Thank you, and I hope you enjoy today's program.
Thank you, Chairman Moore, for those remarks. And at this time, it is a pleasure to introduce our Superintendent of Schools, W. Jeffrey Booker.
Wow. Thank you for being here. You know, when you throw a big party, you always wonder if anybody else show up. And you all have shown up. When we had our parade, there were people that questioned about having a parade. Why would you have a parade? School systems don't have a parade. They participate in parades. We had a parade, did we not? Come on, folks, a little energy. We had a parade. You know, when you think about 50 years spent, people would start to say we're over the hill. I would say the 50 years to look ahead are the 50 years that we will see were the best 50 years of Gaston County schools. And we look forward to doing that. You know, as I reflect on my time as superintendent, which was began in January of 2014, there are people in this room that reached out to me to welcome me into the position. But one came and challenged me. Joel Long came to see me, and he brought this, and he sat it on my counter, and it still sits on my credenza today, because he said, as a leader, you're going to find that saying no is the easiest decision to make. It's safer. You can hide behind all these reasons, but saying yes will take courage, and I want to know you to know that I am behind you saying yes. And we have said yes to many things over the last 5 years. And so I want to thank the people in this room who said yes. For example, at this very event last year, we said we were going to celebrate our 50th anniversary. When I stepped down from the podium, went over to see Mr. went over to see Todd, don't make it easier to say. Pamela Gaff from Wells Fargo came up and immediately said, we want to be a part of that. We commit to whatever the number is. That's partnership. A number of other people are recognized by these plaques. American Eford, Beam Construction, Caremont Health, GSM Services, the Gaston County Education Foundation, and Scribble Software. Many of these folks are longtime partners, and they said, we'll continue to do what we've done, but we'll do this extra to recognize the 50th. And then when we set about having a parade, the first thing, you're talking about hearing no's, the first thing we heard were, how are you going to do a parade? It takes this, it takes this. Well, the city of Gastonia stepped up and said, we will handle security, we will handle this as an in-kind gift to our school system. Mayor, I bet that was worth a little bit more than $5,000, wasn't it, sir? And because of these organizations and all of you in this room, we have truly been able to celebrate our 50th anniversary. Anybody see those billboards that went up during the year? That was from contributions by people in this room. When you take a career and technical education program, remember, we're the 10th largest district in this state. This year, we have an oversight committee that started 5 years ago that challenged us on our career and technical education. What could we do? We don't want to hear about building a building. We don't want to hear about spending money. We want to hear about using the money you have efficiently. Earl Mathers can attest to sitting in those meetings and saying, what will we do with what we have? And they toured all over the East Coast looking at other facilities. At that time, we had a little over 2,000 credentials being earned. This past year, over 12,000 credentials earned by the 10th largest district in North Carolina, second only to Wake County, who has five times the number of students. So for me, I always think about the quote that says, no other investment will yield greater returns than an investment in education. You in this room get that, and we thank you for that, because you have contributed to the success of our students. And I say our students because I think all of us own these kids. Celebrate our kids, support our kids, but most of all, we cherish our kids in this community. Think about what your investment has brought to us. Right sitting over here, stand up, young man. Yes, sir. 25-year-old Johnson and Wales graduate, previous graduate of Ashbrook High School. That is what you invest in. Now part of a business partner, I just go over and introduce by you. Well, we gave the food today. We would support you at other events. That is partnership. We have parents that are grateful for our mentors who walk along a child who may be unsure and say, you can do it. That 1 hour can do so much. I was with the principal last night who has served in several of our schools and currently serving as a high school principal, and a student came up to him from where he had served in a middle school 8 years ago. He was very honest and said, you know, they were a sixth grader. I didn't really remember them, but I said something to them in the hall that they said back to me. Folks, it doesn't take but three or four words to change a life. That's what mentors do. Think about accomplishments. Where's Denise? Miss McClain. Highland School of Technology. We brag when we get one Park Scholar. We got two out of the same high school this year. And then folks want to talk about only part of the county succeeds. Well, I think having a child from Hunter Huss go to Yale, and when he's at Yale visiting, they separated the group, and he went this way, and part of the group went this way, and his father's like, well, what's happening here? Father said, his academic record is so strong, the preparation from his high school, he doesn't have to go with those schools from three private schools in North Carolina to get more work with our counselors. He's already in and done. Hopefully you saw some of the billboards about our Scholastic Art Awards. I don't ever want to take it for granted just because it's something to happen every year. But when you visit our children and look at the artwork that they produce at our art shows, phenomenal. We have the arts alive. You go to Charlotte to the Bloomies and they only give 12 awards and three of them come back to Gaston County. Think about that, folks. That's the arts in Gaston County. When you think about athletics, we have a long tradition of athletics that continues. The same kid that's going to Yale was on a team that didn't lose till they had to play a private school in the quarterfinals of the state playoffs, and they were undefeated, being Hunter Huss High School. So because of all that you have done, we're able to next year take the most aggressive movement in our academic calendar, and that we're going to take our choice programs and expand them to 19 choices next year. And if you saw the presentation the manager made last night, our request to fund that is in his budget, fully funded. That's a support of public education, and it comes because of you. And let's don't forget the little event that happened last spring. Many of you in this room worked tirelessly to say we need to continue improving the physical condition of our schools. We passed a $250 million bond referendum with a 69% approval rate. At the same time, a quarter cent sales tax was put on the ballot, and that will never pass. And I don't care if it was by one vote, it passed, and we've got it, and you all did that. And we look forward to the continued growth. One of those choices that we wanted to, we dreamed about. Dr. Balknight came into my office 2.5 years ago and said, I've heard about this program. She'd done a little bit of background work. She looked at me and said, we could do this program. And my question, what is it going to take? She said, I'm not sure yet, but if we did this, I was like, do it. We took a leap and called a principal at East Gaston High School and said, Jennifer, we want to just add this class next year as a start to something. And then this past fall, we made a phone call to a little company here in town called Caremont Healthcare and said, we really think that we could do something in the health sciences. Chris Peake said, give me the numbers. One presentation, 14, 18 PowerPoint slides, Mr. Peake. He calls back 2 days later, we will fund all below this line, we won't do this line, but over $500,000 commitment over the next 5 years. And that's why you just saw the article in the paper about Caremont Health Sciences Academy at East Gaston High School. The fastest growing field in our country is healthcare, And when you look at the leadership of Caremont and what's going on, and you see where we're partnering with Gaston College, they're partnering with Abby, it's all coming together. And it is an exciting time to watch that. And more will come. You will see more positive announcements between your two largest employers in the community. You all know I could go on and on. And whoever's in the Thursday Rotary, get ready, because I got more to tell y'all tomorrow. But I just want you to know we stand here, you sit, because you said yes. Yes is important. It's a word we all love to hear. But really, when we talk about inspiring success and a lifetime of learning, it doesn't happen without yeses. Without people like you, Gaston County Schools could not have the success it has. So on behalf of 4,000 employees, but more importantly, 31,000 bright children, I say thank you for what you have contributed to our school system. And so I'm going to turn it over to the true master of ceremonies. I will ask you all, this is a man that has lived the 50 years in 1 year. But he said to put up with me saying, really, Todd? You think we are? I did give him some nose on that, Joel. I'm sorry. But seriously, as Todd comes back, could we all please recognize the hard work he has done over the past year?
Thank you all very much. It is, what we've accomplished this year has been wonderful, and I've had a lot of people helping me with it. So we'll talk more about them in a few minutes. Now, to share more about our mentoring program and our business and community partners, please welcome a very familiar face to all of you, our Director of Business and Community Partnerships, Valerie Yatko.
Good afternoon. Thank you, Todd. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to share a moment to talk about two programs that are very, very important to me, our mentoring program and, of course, our business and community partnerships program. Many of you may recall that our mentoring program started over 27 years ago, dating back to 1992, when three individuals from the community went to Washington, D.C. to an education conference, and they heard a national expert on mentoring and determined this is something that could work in Gaston County. And so the idea came back and started small. Those citizens who brought that idea back and started the beginnings of our mentoring program, Stuart LaFrancis, who is here with us today. Stuart. And Teresa Rankin and the late Peggy Newman Sell. They brought that idea back. They found a group of willing volunteers at Burlington Industries and matched them with 10 students. It was 10 individuals that matched with 10 students at Mount Holly, then Mount Holly Junior High School. And that was the birth and the beginning of our mentoring program. Over the past 27 years, obviously the program has grown, and both students and adult lives have been touched by this wonderful, wonderful program and experience, making significant differences in the lives of the children and the adults who have volunteered to mentor. The theme for our mentoring program is the power of one, and it only takes one, one caring individual who's matched with a deserving child to impact that child's life, and as Dr. Booker said, to walk along that child and help ensure that they feel the success and experience many things that sometimes they have to get nudged to try. But that's the power of a mentor. At this time, there are folks in the room that I would like to recognize, and those are some of our mentors that are here with us today. So if you have served as a mentor in Gaston County Schools, I'd like you to stand and please be recognized. Thank you all for taking the time to be with us today. We also have with us some of the folks that make this program happen, and that are the employees at the school who serve as mentor coordinators. And not all are here today, but some are, and if you are a mentor coordinator, I'd also like to ask you to please stand and be recognized. Don't be shy. Because of those folks, our program is strong. They are the ones that are really the boots on the ground, if you will, that make this program move forward and make those matches and continue to help ensure that those relationships grow and the children are well served. As a small token of our appreciation this afternoon, too, we would like to ask all the mentors and the mentor coordinators on your way out to please stop at the registration desk. We do have a small token of our appreciation for you, so please stop by the desk and see the folks out there. You will receive a lapel pin with a very powerful saying on it. It says, mentoring is powerful, and we do believe that as we have witnessed so many success stories among our students in our mentoring program. So we hope you'll wear your pin proudly. And when someone asks you, please share your story. Sometimes it often takes a mentor to recruit another mentor. So please do share those very, very meaningful stories about your relationships. Please know that we appreciate each and every one of you. We also value the organizations that partner with our school system, many businesses, many organizations who, again, have, as Dr. Booker said yes to our request. Some of the significant ones, First ARP Church, well, they're all significant, I must preface that. First ARP Church has supplied many, many mentors to one of our schools. Man Hummel, also very, very powerful in our mentoring program. United Methodist Missional Network. Law enforcement agencies. We're very happy to have local police and fire from the city of Gastonia and the county. The Belmont Abbey Benz basketball team. These are all folks who have come and supported and given an hour, up to an hour each week to support our students. As I said, not only do we have the pleasure of working with our mentors, but we do take pride in our business and community partnerships as well. And because of our partnerships, we have some wonderful things, as the annual Evening of Excellence that honors our outstanding employees, and including our annual Teacher of the Year and our Principal of the Year. As Dr. Buchter also mentioned, the Gaston Regional Science and Engineering Fair often will give a starting point to our students to showcase their significant and scientific research. For the sixth consecutive year, we've partnered with KIA of Gastonia to host the KIA Outstanding Educator Awards, when one deserving employee will win a brand new car. Our business community is very involved in our career and technical education programs that connect the students, of course, to the professional world. And because of our partnerships, we've seen much success in the areas of career and technical education. And the project at Webb Street School, the wonderful playground, all-inclusive playground project, that is a perfect example of how a business and community partner can come together to make a vision a reality. Those are just a few examples. I really could stand here and go on and on, but I know I must move on. But you are all very important to us, and we thank you for your continued support and interest in serving our students in Gaston County Schools. Thanks again for being with us, and I am so proud of what we have accomplished together in this past year, and I look forward to work with each and every one of you, and we will make year 51 the best yet. Thank you.
Thank you, Valerie. Each year during our Mentor Appreciation Program, it has become a tradition to present the Paul F. Fuller Scholarship to a deserving student who has been involved in our mentoring program. The scholarship is named in memory of Paul Fuller, who was one of our very first mentors. This scholarship program began in 2001, and since then, the students who have received the Paul Fuller Scholarship have gone on to graduate from college and enjoy successful careers in construction, photography, banking, education, business, and other areas. This year, we are presenting scholarships to three deserving high school seniors. The first scholarship is the Paul Fuller Scholarship for Trades and Technical Training. This scholarship is a one-time $500 award for a student who has an interest in a trade or technical field. Funding for the scholarship is made possible by the Gastonia Noon Optimist Club. The recipient plans to attend Gaston College to study information technology with a special interest in cyber defense. He hopes to use his degree working for a manufacturing company. I'm going to ask Dr. Booker to come forward, and Valerie, please come forward for the presentation of the Paul Fuller Scholarship for Trades and Technical Training to Caleb Moore from Hunter Huss High School. At Hunter Huss, Caleb is a member of the baseball team, which he says has given him the opportunity to learn the true meaning of teamwork. He credits his teacher, Amy Wooten, for serving as his mentor during his career and technical education classes. Because of Mrs. Wooten, Caleb says he was able to complete three different career certifications in advanced manufacturing. Congratulations to Caleb Moore from Hunter Huss High School. The Paul Fuller Scholarship for Mentored Students is a $1,000 per year award that is renewable for 4 years for a total of $4,000. This year, we used some of our Big 50 anniversary funds to increase the scholarship to $1,250 per year for a total of $5,000. For our 50th anniversary, we thought it was only appropriate to give a Paul Fuller Scholarship that totals $5,000. We are presenting scholarships to two outstanding students who have been involved in our mentoring program. Our first recipient is Jacob Hunt from Forest View High School. Jacob, please come forward to accept your scholarship from Dr. Booker. Jacob says that mentoring changed him and made a significant difference in his life. He was first mentored while in the fourth grade, and his mentor helped him with math and English, teaching him a few neat tricks that helped when it came to multiplying fractions and working with verbs, tricks that he still uses today. Jacob says, having a mentor during my early years helped me out tremendously, dramatically changing my life for the better in the mental and social benefits that I have to gain from the experience. Jacob plans to attend college and pursue a career in law enforcement. Congratulations, Jacob Hunt from Forest View High School, one of our Paul Fuller Scholarship recipients for the class of 2019. Our second recipient is Anthony Perez from Hunter Huss High School. Anthony, if you will come forward to accept your scholarship from Dr. Booker. Anthony says his mentor was there to listen, support, and give advice, which meant a lot to him during his elementary and middle school years. Not only did he have a mentor, Anthony had a role model. Today, Anthony says he finds himself trying to help, support, and motivate others because of the example his mentor established for him. Anthony says, having a mentor made me a better person. It made me into a strong and determined person who is always aiming for success. Anthony plans to attend college to pursue a career as a meteorologist, furthering his interest in the fascinating science of weather. Congratulations, Anthony Perez from Hunter Huss High School, one of our Paul Fuller Scholarship recipients for the class of 2019. And thank you, Dr. Booker and Valerie, for your help with those presentations of those awards. Today's program is being recorded for future broadcast on Spectrum Cable Channel 21, which is the education station for Gaston County Schools. So we would like to encourage our TV audience to become involved in our mentoring program. As you can tell from hearing a little about Anthony, Jacob, and Caleb, mentoring is a rewarding experience for both the student and the adult, and it takes only 1 hour a week to be a positive influence. If you would like more information about our mentoring program, please visit the Gaston County Schools website and click on the Volunteers and Mentors icon on the homepage. Now we are ready to recognize and honor the business and community partners with us this afternoon that have offered support to Gaston County Schools over the past year. Here is how our recognition will work. We are going to ask that the honorees with a white index card that you received at registration when you arrived to please gather on this side of the room in a line. You do not have to be in any particular order. One at a time, you will hand me your card, and as I call your name, please accept your certificate of appreciation that features our 50th anniversary logo from Superintendent Booker and members of the Board of Education. The first group to be recognized this afternoon is the business and community partners who have made contributions up to $5,000. And as we recognize our honorees, please hold your applause until the end. Our first business partner is Hickory Tavern. And if you will go over and accept your certificate from Dr. Booker. Next we have CarMax. The Gaston County Art and History Museum. The Gaston Regional Chamber and Leadership Gaston. The McCaddenville Women's Club and 115 Main Gifts and Provisions. PNC Bank. Will's Doggin' It Deli. St. John's Lutheran Church of Cherville.
Missionary Baptist.
Emmanuel Missionary Baptist Church. First Wesleyan Church of Cherville and First Presbyterian Church of Cherville. BB&T Bank. Beckham Floors. Lanxess. Christ United Methodist Church. Lutheran Chapel Church. Dallas Baptist Church and Good Shepherd Lutheran Church of Mount Holly. The second group to recognize this afternoon is the business and community partners who have made contributions that exceeded $5,000. If you have a red index card, please line up on this side of the room at this time. We are pleased to recognize our business and community partners who have made contributions that exceed $5,000. We begin with Women Optimizing Wellness. Holy Trinity Lutheran Church. Gaston Hope in Christ. Rankin Lake Baptist Church. The United Way. Firestone Fibers and Textiles. Gaston College. Bradley Memorial United Methodist Church. First ARP Church of Gastonia. First United Methodist Church of Mount Holly. Myers Memorial United Methodist Church, and the Little Red Schoolhouse Program. The Shield Museum. Keep Gastonia Beautiful. Kate's Skating Rink. The Community Foundation of Gaston County. First Baptist Church of Gastonia. Calvary Baptist Church. Catawba Heights Baptist Church. Park Street United Methodist Church. The Backpack Weekend Food Program. The Bessemer City Fundraising Committee. Man Hummel. The Gaston Family Health Services Dental Clinic. Queen of the Apostles Catholic Church. Livent Corporation. Tyndall Ford Subaru Roush. Christ Lutheran Church of Stanley. Thank you to all of our business and community partners for 2018-2019, our 50th anniversary school year. And thank you, Dr. Booker, and members of the Board of Education for helping with that presentation. Many people have supported, been involved in, and worked behind the scenes to make our Big 50 anniversary celebration a success. A 50th anniversary happens only once, and we are so grateful for everyone who has made our year-long observance golden. If we took time this afternoon to name everyone who has contributed to our celebration, we would be here all night. That's how many people have helped us this year. However, today, we want to bring attention to two groups, the eight presenting sponsors who provided the financial support needed for such a large-scale celebration, and our Big 50 Anniversary Planning Committee who, beginning in January 2018, took on the responsibility of making our vision for a year-long celebration a reality. At this time, we would like to recognize our presenting sponsors. When I call your name, please come forward to accept your presenting sponsor plaque from Superintendent Booker. And Mr. Moore, if you will help us with this presentation as well. We have for each of you your plaque that we hope that you will display proudly. And we also have for you a special edition commemorative coin that features our Big 50 anniversary logo. And we will recognize our presenting sponsors in alphabetical order, beginning with American and Eford, John Boyer. Beam Construction Company, Susie Lewis and Robert Brown. Caramont Health, Chris Peak and Bree Hager. GSM Services, Joel Long. The Gaston County Education Foundation, Amy Spencer. the City of Gastonia, Mayor Walker Reed and Christy Crisp. Scribbles Software, Bridget Jones. And Wells Fargo, Pamela Gaff and Justin White. These are the companies and organizations that provided the financial support to make our celebration happen. Thank you so very much. Let's have one more round of applause for them. And Chairman Moore and Dr. Booker, if you will stay right where you're at, we've got a few more things for you to help us with today. Now we would like to honor the members of the Big 50 Anniversary Planning Committee. When I call your name, please come forward to accept your commemorative 50th anniversary coin from Dr. Booker and Chairman Moore. As you come forward, I will share just one of the ways that you were involved in making our celebration happen. We begin with Brian Denton, the principal of Hunter Huss High School. Mr. Denton was so gracious to host the auditions at Hunter Huss for our employee talent show. Next, Audrey Devine, principal of Stuart W. Kramer High School. Mrs. Devine made her school auditorium available to us for several of our special events. Chad Duncan, Director of Athletics for Gaston County Schools. Mr. Duncan served as our liaison with the school athletic directors to coordinate our sports history exhibit. Theresa Greer, Parent Involvement Specialist at Lingerfelt Elementary. Ms. Greer was the first person in line to volunteer and make our Big 50 Ensemble singing group so wonderful. Cindy Owens, band director at W.C. Friday Middle School. Mrs. Owens took on the responsibility of directing our employee band for our back-to-school convocation last August. Philip Ratchford, the coordinator for after-school programs in our academic services department. And I do not believe that Philip could be with us this afternoon, but he served as one of our parade day coordinators, handling the disbandment of the parade, and what a job that was. Next, we have Jacqueline Robinson, the chorus director at Hunter Huss High School. And Valerie, I know she's here with her chorus. Will you see if she's... We'll get Jacqueline in here because she deserves recognition. While Valerie is looking for her, we will recognize Julian Wilson, the band director at York Chester Middle School. Mr. Wilson coordinated literally everything for our Big 50 Ensemble singing group. And now Jacqueline Robinson, the chorus director at Hunter Huss High School. And you will see Mrs. Robinson's influence when her students perform for us in just a few minutes. And Valerie Yatko, Director of Business and Community Partnerships. Mrs. Yatko, well, she did a little bit of everything, but most important, she made the phone calls to secure our sponsorships last summer. It has been a pleasure working with each of you, and on behalf of our superintendent and our Board of Education, we express our gratitude to the committee members for serving this past year as our planning committee for the 50th anniversary. There actually is a third group that I personally want to thank, and this group is the Gaston County Schools Communications Department. This year, when we had opportunities, as we like to call them, for the 50th anniversary come our way, my team stepped up in a big way to handle their regular duties and also take on extra work. So I would like to acknowledge Tom Nansetti, Sean Corcoran, Allison Drennan, Charlotte Wright, Valerie Yatko, Maurice Johnson, Jennifer Blanton, and also Dana Luwato for all of their outstanding efforts this year. We also would like to say a big thank you to the Gaston County Schools Facilities Department for their assistance with this event, as well as the staff here at the Gastonia Conference Center for being so accommodating. And we want to say thank you to Gaston Floral Gardens in Dallas for providing the floral arrangements for today's program. Now, we have a very special performance by the Hunter Huss High School Chorus under the direction of longtime choral director Jacqueline Robinson, who is completing her 39th year in education. The students will perform two songs. The first one is titled A Ka Kom Bar Ewa. I hope I said that correctly. The title translates to Shown Blessing, and it is sung traditionally as a benediction, which is very appropriate as we bring our 50th anniversary to a close. The students will sing in Latin and Shon, which is the language of the majority Shona tribe in Zimbabwe. The lyrics translate to, "Blessed are they who come in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest." Please welcome the Hunter Huss High School Chorus.
Benedictus,
before the chorus sings our finale. Seasons of Love, from the award-winning Broadway musical Rent, the song poses a question. 525,600 minutes, how do we measure a year? If you notice the pictures and display in the lobby as you came in this afternoon, you know that we have measured our Big 50 anniversary this year with a back-to-school convocation that many of our employees said was our best ever. A 90-unit parade marching through downtown Gastonia, complete with 23 special guests, 13 professional floats, 10 high school marching bands, students from every school, cheerleaders, JROTC units, and other marching groups, and one book bug who you saw in the lobby today. A pictorial display at the Gaston County Public Library that featured 50 of our best pictures from the Big 50 Parade. An exhibit at the Gaston County Museum in Dallas that highlighted our rich sports history over the past 50 years. An employee talent show that showcased 8 awesome employee acts and amazing performances by our Big 50 ensemble. We also had history-related posts on Facebook, special programming on Channel 21, a variety of school-level activities to bring attention to our anniversary celebration, and today we've had our Big 50 reception. This certainly has been a year to remember, and we have loved every minute of it. For our final performance, here is the Hunter Huss High School Chorus.
Thank you.
big round of applause for the Hunter High School Chorus. To everyone here today, thank you for your many wonderful contributions to our schools. We appreciate you being with us, and we look forward to another 50 years of excellence in education for Gaston County Schools. Year 51, here we come. Have a great evening, everyone.